Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Hi, graduates and families. I'm Ms. Sherwood, Bowsher High School principal. Graduation, this is the day I look most forward to all year long. It's sad not to be on a stage looking out upon each of you, seeing your excitement and your grins from ear to ear. Here I am instead at the Big B. I feel like the bell should ring any minute and I need to start yelling at everyone to get to class on time. Never thought I'd miss a memory like that. On August 18, 2016, I talked to you at Freshman First Day. I remember telling you that 4 years may seem like a long time, but your high school days would be over before you knew it. Who could have guessed it would have ended this way? Typically, we have 180 days together your senior year to create the memories that last a lifetime. The memories this year are vastly different for this class. Your graduating class will forever be remembered as the quarantine class of 2020. American author F. Scott Fitzgerald said, "Never confuse a single defeat with a final defeat. Graduation isn't the end of some road, but the first step to the next chapter of your adventures." We have seen ingenuity and creativeness with the graduates of 2020, as you've had to deal with your senior year ending completely different than expected. I suspect this class will go forth and conquer with a ferociousness we haven't seen in past years. I suspect this class will be the change makers of our future. Missed opportunities the past 8 weeks should be our wake-up call that life is precious. We can no longer take our tomorrows for granted. When you wake up tomorrow as the most recent alumni group of Bowsher High School, the class of 2020, I want you to take your first step toward your dreams and never stop. It doesn't matter if you take small baby steps or giant leaps, you just need to keep moving forward. Oprah Winfrey shared this advice: "Forget about the fast lane. If you really want to fly, just harness your power to your passion. Honor your calling. Everyone has one. Trust your heart and success will come to you." You have worked hard to enter the workforce, enroll in college, or enlist in the military upon graduation. Take your very unique senior year experience, your once-in-a-lifetime challenge, to fuel your future dreams. I want to thank our Bowsher families for helping your child get to this point. Since kindergarten, you've played an integral part in your child's life and education. You supported your schools and teachers. You volunteered. You sent in school supplies. You made late night runs to the store when your child forgot to tell you about the project that was due the next day. You helped with homework, and most recently, you became homeschool teachers. And speaking of teachers, our Bowsher teachers deserve a huge thank you for supporting these students the past 4 years. They've worked tirelessly to help our graduates become the best of themselves. And this past 8 weeks, I'm amazed how the teachers have stepped up to the plate with little warning, with little time to prepare, with varying degrees of virtual teaching prowess to teach and support our graduates remotely. A big thank you to our support family, the administrators, the clerical staff, food services, and facility services. They are some of the unseen and unsung heroes. In parting, to the class of 2020, you are enough exactly as you are. You have what it takes to succeed. You've successfully managed to get through every single good and bad day up to this point. You are batting 100. The unknown and the lack of safety nets can be scary as you leave high school, but it's an awesome freedom to know that you can forge your own path, the path that only you can create to leave your legacy. Please remember us, your Rebel family, and be sure to share your success stories with us. We will forever remember you. And as you continue to watch the rest of your commencement ceremony, have your cap and gown on hand for the official tassel turn at the end. Congratulations, seniors.
I have the honor of introducing our guest speaker, Dr. Durant. TPS Proud isn't just a catchphrase for the Toledo native, Dr. Romulus Durant. In everything he says and does, and wears, Dr. Durant shows his unwavering commitment to Toledo Public Schools. A graduate of Waite High School, Dr. Durant has received 3 degrees from the University of Toledo, a Bachelor of Education degree in 1998, a Master's of Education degree in 2002, and a Doctorate degree in Educational Administration and Supervision in 2007. Employed by TPS since 1999, Dr. Durant has been a fourth grade teacher, a dean, an assistant principal, a principal, and an assistant superintendent before being named the top position in December 2013. In Dr. Durant's tenure as superintendent, Toledo Public Schools has seen its ranking among Ohio's largest urban school districts jump from fourth to first on the state report card. Because of an A grade in the all student growth category in 2 of the last 3 years, Dr. Durant is particularly proud of using progressive measures such as pathways to college degree tracks and pipelines to various industries, with the addition of 100 more industry partners offering internships. The district continues to progress towards universal pre-K for all students. While his honors are many, Dr. Durant has never lost sight of the fact that he has the same goal for today's TPS students as he had for himself: to rise up from modest means to achieve success in school and then in life. Welcome, Dr. Durant.
Hello, TPS Proud graduates, family members, and community members. We appreciate you taking part in this virtual ceremony, graduate of 2020. Before I get started, I would like us all to take a moment of silence for those who have fallen ill or have lost their lives during the struggle and fight of this current pandemic. With that said, I think it's a time also for excitement. So again, I want to congratulate you here at TPS Proud, graduate of 2020, in regard to all that you've endured. But I come to you by way of Waite High School, where I'm a graduate of class of 94, and I also brought my own graduation purple cap that I had once walked the same lanes and celebrated the same honor that each and every one of you will do today. But I say it's an honor to be with you today, because today is about life expectation. It's about life perception and how you perceive things. And that, yes, you could say, oh, we don't get a traditional graduation, or you could talk about your city of Toledo and all those things, but I always tell people it's a matter of your perspective. It's a matter, in essence, of how you look at it and say, you know, we are the first to ever have a virtual graduation, to ever have a drive-through and a presentation. I still took a picture when my superintendent had a diploma that I could put and post throughout the house, a variety of things in the history of Toledo Public Schools. At the same time, I'm from one of the best cities and the country, the backbone of the United States, and manufacturing, agriculture, all the things that go on and thrive within the country of the United States. But again, your perspective is what drives you, as well as your motivation, and it's those things that carries a positivity about your life, but more importantly, a positivity about today of being graduates here at Toledo Public Schools. I say to you, at the same time, you have no idea of how proud I am of the class of 2020. Understand, many of you were born into the world of chaos, meaning many of you were born during the time of 9/11, when it was the most heightened fear within the United States with the attack on the Twin Towers in New York City. Many people were frantic, and at the time where many of you have came in at that who were 18 and 19 year old were born into this world. But at the same time, you strive down because that tells me there's character built within this generation. And then as you got into the high school, the state had changed your pathway more than a few times. There was nothing more frustrating to me to see the faces of our students who said one minute they were on track, one minute they were off track, merely because there was a change in the guideline for pathway to graduation. You withstood and withstood the time of those changes because today you're going to be graduates. But it showed a test of your character. And then all of a sudden, your prom, spring sports, at the same time, traditional graduation was at the mercy of a pandemic and stay-at-home order. Again, we're rising above those expectations today because we had one of the first in virtual, as well as many other things that we're going to do to celebrate our class of 2020. But this begins to define your character. Understand about adversity truly defines who you are as a person. Martin Luther King once said that a person's not measured about where they stand during a time of comfort, but where they stand during a time of adversity, controversy. Certain sayings such as today, where do you stand in those lights? Do you stress yourself or do you fight through with the will to succeed to show I will rise above the situation? Because at the end of the day, I'm greater than the expectations. And again, I'm excited for each and every one of you and what you're going to set out to do and set forth. It's important that you continue during this whole pandemic at the stay-at-home order. You truly had time to value your family, begin to develop relationships among siblings as well as family members, truly getting to know individuals because you were within a household or doing a lot of activity together. For the first time, I've heard many families who begin to start eating more as a family at a set time. More than I've seen now than any other time, people actually enjoying nature and the park systems, which had been forgotten with the technology age. People continue to value those resources, continue to value your relationship within your family, because at the end of the day, they're the foundation that brought you into this world, and they will be the backbone that carry you through it. At some point, your shoulders will be stood upon by students or children of the lower generation following your footsteps. I give you words of advice as you begin to move forward in your endeavor out after graduation. Continue to provide a plan for your life. Continue to move and understand what you plan to do tomorrow, what you plan to do in your 30 days, your 60 days, your 3 months, your 6 months, as well as your year to 3 to 5 years. You literally have to have an intentional plan about what you want to do with yourself. Whether it's a pandemic or not a pandemic, whether it's a stay-at-home or learning from home or not a learning from home, you have to have a sense of what you want to do with the rest of your life. Take this time to research this out. I tell you to limit your time on Facebook, limit your time on Twitter, Instagram, limit the time of watching the latest dance on TikTok. Yeah, that's right. Dr. Durant knows all about TikTok. Don't be surprised if you see a TPS shuffle on TikTok. But limit the time on social media to spend that time in your research, to be able to study opportunities that you think you truly want to do with your life. What does it take to get there? Meaning, what do I need to take courses? Do I need to get a certification? Do I need to get a degree? Who are the people in that industry? Can I volunteer to learn more about it? Can I do an internship to know more about it? Can I ultimately develop a relationship with those who work there to ultimately employ me into that field? That's all dependent on you. At this point in time, the stage of the game, that ultimately at the end of the day, What you look at and you figure it out for yourself today is gonna be a reflection of your tomorrow. If you're still holding and standing still, guess what? Nothing changes at 25. Before you know it, people are staying 30 years old, still standing, figuring what they wanna do with their life. Be intentional about those things. Start developing support around you to get opportunity to be able to see other things outside of what you've already seen here at TPS. Have the largest career technical program in Northwest Ohio, as well as other opportunities in college credits and other things. But there are now more to research as you begin to evolve into adulthood, but more importantly, seeking out what you want to do with the rest of your life. Begin to understand the programs that are out there, the courses that you will need to take, the scholarship that you need to apply for. Never tell yourself no about the scholarship. At the end of the day, you may be one of few who actually apply. Apply it to many of those things. Do not look to go into your own pocket. Look to spend the money of others that ultimately provide scholarships to support you on your educational endeavor. Begin to look to do more volunteer within your community to truly build relationships with those within the effort of furthering yourself spiritually, but more importantly, furthering yourself career-wise as well as a person. I say continue with this grind in an aspect of your life. Understand your dreams are your dreams and no one else. At the end of the day, it's about your will and your determination that decides your ultimate outcome. It's about what you want to do with yourself, what you strive to do within your 48 hours. No one should expect more of you than you. You should have the highest expectation of yourself, that you look down on yourself, that no one else looks down on you, because your greatness is beyond anyone else's expectation of what they can see in you. You do not let a pandemic hold you down. You become your own pandemic within this life. You are the pandemic of what you do. It's your contagion that makes others feel your will and your effort. It's that pandemic that gives others a 101 fever about you, because they burning up inside because of you. They're burning up of that fever because it's your pandemic. Your will is so contagious that everyone around you want greatness because of you. Do not let a coronavirus should be named after you because of your contagion on other people. Because your effort and your will has caused others to do greatness because they seen it in you. Again, you are the outcome, the biggest boss of your life. You are the CEO of everything that you do. People will follow your leadership. Again, be the pandemic of yourself. There is no bigger coronavirus than you, because it's your virus that is contagious within your family and those around you. The more they see that you want, the more they begin to understand that they may need to want more too. Their expectation changes because of you. I say develop a social IQ, not just an intelligence IQ, and understanding math, trig, and science, and all those other things. Develop a social IQ about emotional aspects of people. You should know the various social economic status of people, whether you're someone who comes with money, someone who come from a working class family, or someone who's seen and come from a household of a lot of money. Understanding the mindset and the culture of each and every person, you should have a social IQ of understanding people, because understand children as well as people don't care what you know until they know you care. When you show a person you care, it defines you, but more importantly, they want to be around you, because at the end of the day, they know you will further themselves. You will become a support for them. At the end of the day, again, your contagion impacts them. Have a social IQ, have an understanding of people, what stresses them. Have an understanding of the hardship, the drive. Understand where a person's coming from. Don't look at their situation, look down on them. Understand where they come from that got them in the first place. And then put a hand out, in essence, if you can help, help. Be a support to that. But when you do, you have a social IQ and understanding of people. And people always appreciate someone who's compassionate about what they do. I always tell people a story that I used to go to the car wash, and there was a gentleman who used to wash the car, and he was there religiously every day on the east side. And I remember I say to him when I get out the car, hey, how you doing? And so forth, and he ignored me. And I said to him twice, three days in a row, ignored me. And at first I said to myself, you know what, forget this guy. If he don't want to respond to me, he thinks he can't respond to me, why should I even give him the benefit of doubt, even say anything to him? But then I said, you know, that's not what my father raised. My father didn't instill that character in me. He made me look all people in the eyes. At the end of the day, when you come past me, I'm gonna address you with love one way or another. You fail to address me back as a character flaw in you. After 2 weeks of doing it, the man stopped and said to me, you know what? When you first said it, I didn't think you cared. When you first said it, I thought you were just doing it as part of a ritual to say to people. But you consistently asked me every day despite I ignored you. You will always get a greeting from me. I will always respect you in a way and support and saying positive back to you, because obviously you must care if you're gonna be that intentional of saying stuff to me. Again, you don't let others define your character. You define your character for yourself. You don't let other people change you for the worse. You change them for the better. You change their spiritual outlook. You change their spiritual impact. When they see you, they want better to say something positive to you because you brought positive to them. Again, happiness is about what's in you. Happiness is about, in essence, of what you can give. Happiness is about a choice that you make within yourself. If you want to be happy, be happy. At the end of the day, you'd be surprised how many people around you are happy. Social IQ is the key to success, ultimately, in today's industry. How well you relate to people, understand people, and help them strive to be better within their work, as well as being as a person. I tell you to continue to build your support system within you. Many times, your number one support is your family. Students, your biggest fan is your family. Your biggest internet troll is your family. Your biggest groupie is your family. When they hear your name announced on 88.3 across the next stage to get that diploma, guess what? The groupies are clapping. The groupies are taking pictures of you because they're your biggest support system. But understand, continue to broaden your support system. You got families, you got teachers, you got administrators, you got community members. There's no Dr. Grant at this platform without people such as that who supported me along the way. And I never forget about them. So again, never forget about where you come from, who you are as a person, and the name that you represent. You was given a first name, but more importantly, you were given a last name to represent somebody, child. A last name to represent something. You've been given a community to represent that community. You've been given a high school to represent. I will never forget Wade High School. Never forget I come from the East Side. I look out my window every morning and say, you see that over there? That's called the East Side. God's country. Every morning my wife laughs when I do it. But again, it's an appreciation because it's a view that I get to see every morning, and many of you would be able to do the same as you grow within your life. I continue to offer myself to you because I'm a servant leader and serving you as students and serving you as a community member. I've written more letters of recommendation than I could think of. And the more I ask, the more I shall receive. I tell kids all the time, as well as others, a closed mouth don't get fed. You say nothing, you get nothing. You need something, speak up. You can always get a hold of me on email. Don't use social media, email me. At mytps.email, I always respond within 24 hours. Letter recommendation. If I know inputs on certain locations of jobs, if I know employers, I have no problem speaking on your behalf because you are a graduate of TPS. And when I hire people, I always look first who came from TPS, because we have a responsibility to employ you. We have a responsibility that we brought you through with education, that you're good enough to make sure that you work with us, that we can ultimately provide employment. And that's always been a highest priority in our HR department. So again, continue to be proud. I'm honored to be able to speak to each and every one of you from a virtual location, and we get to drive through. We're gonna be face to face, hand you your diploma, take a picture, and be proud of you as you walk off that stage. Again, I am a TPS graduate class of 94. Today, you are all proud graduates of TPS, class of 2020. Celebrate, be excited, be blessed, and I'm proud of each and every one of you, and stay safe. Thank you.
Caroline Sweeney is the daughter of Dr. Calvin and Christine Sweeney, of whom both are proud TPS teachers. Caroline has been a Bowsher Rebel for all 4 years of her high school career. During her time at Bowsher, she was very involved in both her community and school. Caroline participated in Youth Leadership Toledo, National Honor Society, Junior Class Council, where she was treasurer, and Student Council, where she is president. Caroline was also involved in athletics, where she was a four-year varsity cross-country runner. In her community, Caroline volunteered on a regular basis at local food pantries. Some of Caroline's fondest memories are as being a student aide for Ms. Bell and Ms. Nieves and taking her statistics with her cross-country coach, Mr. Hershey. Caroline was accepted into 7 colleges and received full rides to Kalamazoo College, Dartmouth College, and the University of Pittsburgh. After graduation, Caroline will be majoring in neuroscience at the University of Pittsburgh and hopes to continue on into medical school to achieve her goal of becoming a neurologist.
Good afternoon. My name is Carolyn Sweeney, and I'm the valedictorian of Bowsher High School. I'd like to say hello to my fellow graduates, teachers, and to family and friends. There is no nice way to broach the topic. We are living through a global pandemic. Businesses and schools were closed, and events and plans have been canceled. But some families have lost much more than that. I want to take the time to acknowledge any family who has lost a family member, job, or even their peace of mind. As seniors, we have lost special memories and moments. We have no prom, no senior week, no skip day or prank. Although, Mr. Patterson, you should be grateful for that, because we definitely had plans for you. And most of all, we lost our ability to have a regular graduation. Together, we are all grieving our senior year. There are 5 stages of grief: denial, anger, bargaining, depression or sadness, and acceptance. I know we may not be at a place to accept the fate of our senior year yet, but hopefully today we can get a little closer to that. I'd like to take a very quick moment to thank the people who helped me get to this place today. I'd like to thank my immediate family and extended family, as well as close family friends. I'd also like to give a special thanks to Ms. Nieves, Mr. Leonard, Mr. Hershey, Ms. Bell, and Mr. Ashley, who went above and beyond helping me and also got a nice earful of my complaints. Today, I hope to leave you with a sense of hope and a little bit of closure. This is not the first time we have faced challenges during our academic careers. We worked through the denial that it would take more than one night of work to do a paper the correct way. We went through the disbelief that mysteriously all our teachers had projects and tests due on the same day. Although not very successfully, we attempted to bargain with our teachers to extend due dates. We all survived junior SAT day, a day I don't think any of us would say is a happy occasion. And we learned to accept that despite our pleas, our teachers would still give us exams at the end of our courses. But I think many of my classmates would say our greatest achievement was passing geometry. But we didn't just overcome challenges together, we made memories along the way too. Together we got booed and applauded at pep rallies, froze our way through football games, and quite literally ran through the hallways to avoid hall sweeps. I say all that to remind you that although we lost something, we have gained so much. You did survive high school and you made it to graduation. Class of 2020, if we can make it through high school, we can make it through this pandemic. We are strong and resilient, and we have a host of classmates and memories to help us along the way. I can't wait to see what our future holds for us.
Liana Butler is the daughter of Kevin and Lynette Butler. She attended Bowsher High School all 4 years and participated in multiple activities. Throughout her years, she's played volleyball, basketball, and ran track. Her plan after graduation include furthering her education in the electrician field and playing college volleyball. She hopes to become a master electrician and help those around her become better.
Hello, Bowsher family and friends. My name is Liana Butler, and I'm the proud salutatorian of the class of 2020. Obviously, this is not how we wanted to celebrate our last 4 years. We all imagined spending our last month of high school, attending prom, participating in senior week, and making our last memories before life gets real. Even though we did not get to finish out together, I personally want to say that I am proud of us seniors. Whether it was preparing for our last DECA competitions, studying for our last projects, or even practicing to win our last championships, over this past year, we have all accomplished something we'll never forget. My favorite part of high school was being a part of the Bowsher volleyball team. Beginning in the seventh grade, I became a part of a family that not only taught me how to be a leader, but also let me know how good it feels to win back-to-back championships. Throughout my years of playing volleyball, I became a better athlete and a better young woman. I'd like to thank Coach Stuart Jesse for emphasizing to me the importance of working hard and staying consistent. I have always had a passion to help others strive to be better. As the team captain, I was given the opportunity to use my leadership skills to benefit my team. Being a part of the volleyball program taught me lessons that I can use on the court, in the classroom, and throughout my life. Aside from the athletic accomplishments, I'd like to thank one teacher specifically for always pushing me to be better. Anyone who knows me knows that I am not a big fan of science, but for some reason, I like chemistry. Mr. Leonard taught me all about chemical reactions, and I have never enjoyed doing labs as much as I did in his class. Mr. Leonard was one of the biggest influencers in my high school years. Not only did he make everything easy to understand, but he taught me beyond just chemistry. He taught me what it means to embrace my strength and my wisdom, and for that, I will forever be thankful for him. Being salutatorian is one accomplishment I am very proud of. Of course, I couldn't have done it without the help of my family and friends. I'd like to thank my mom, my dad, my siblings, and my aunts for always pushing me to keep striving. I'd especially like to thank my Uncle Melvin Thomas Sr. for shaping me into the woman I am today as well. You may not be here to celebrate with me, but your lessons and love will always be cherished. I know you're in heaven kicking it with the big dogs, bragging about your niece. As we come to closing the door to our high school years, we prepare to open the door to new opportunities. One of the biggest lessons I've learned is to appreciate what we have while we have it. Don't be afraid to love hard, to take risks, and to put your all into what you do. Like they say, it's not just about the destination, but about the journey along the way. Congratulations, class of 2020, and as always, to God be the glory.
Hello. On behalf of the Toledo Public Schools Board of Education, it is my pleasure to accept the credentials of the graduating Bowsher High School class of 2020. Congratulations, graduates. I would like to thank the parents, guardians, grandparents, relatives, and mentors for all the support you've provided to these phenomenal graduates. Our students are successful both because of their own hard work, but also because of your support. Additionally, I would like to thank the teachers, administrators, and staff who work every day to surround these students with a respect for and a love for learning, and who teach students about the hard work that is truly the path to success. To you, the graduates, it is an honor to speak to you today. I wish it could have been different from this and more traditional, but I want to congratulate you on persevering through this time. It may be difficult to see right now, but each of you looks towards a future that is markedly better because you are a high school graduate, and I am proud of the path that each and every one of you followed to be here today. Whether you are headed to college or directly to a career, there will be a place for you to make a difference as you go out into the world. In this uncertain time, I know three things that are important for you as you move forward. First, I ask that you find ways to be of service in your community, perhaps in your chosen profession or in a volunteer activity. You will soon see opportunities for mentorships of those younger or less experienced, and ways to integrate your work into bettering your community. But you don't need to wait to be fully into your career. Volunteer opportunities abound, both in our community and any American community where you may find yourself. To arrive at this point of being a high school graduate, you have developed self-knowledge about your skills and abilities. Be sure to use some of them. The world will be better for it. Secondly, I ask that you take care of you. As high school graduates, many of you juggled school and work, student clubs, and practice for athletics, and sometimes all of those things. I'm sure you've already been in a situation where the have-to-get-done items take precedence over the probably should get done for your health items. Keep in mind, you cannot complete those have-to-get-done items unless you remain healthy. Please be cautious in this immediate time, and it's always good to sleep and eat your vegetables. Get exercise and tend to your health. Remember also, you are a true digital native, some of the first in this generation. And for your entire lives, you have been processing information at a volume that human brains never have before. Give yourself a break sometimes. Unplug and tend to your mental health without any shame so that you really can walk the path forward that you're creating for yourself. And finally, I would ask that you never be afraid to alter your path. As we see now, sometimes in life, you can be 99% certain that you know your direction, and then that 0.1% opportunity presents itself. It may present itself as a challenge, but yet, there will still be opportunities through those challenges. It's not only okay to pivot, it is brave. Be open. You never know what a willingness to change might bring about. We live in a time and a society that feels fractured and unsettled, but when I see you, our future, I have hope and faith for a better world. Congratulations, graduates. I cannot wait to see all that you contribute to this world.
As has already been said, this is not the graduation that we expected, but I knew that the class of 2020 was ready. I've had the privilege of starting my time at Bowsher at the same time as the class of 2020 freshmen. I've learned many things from you. Mistakes can be overcome. You can push through when no one thinks you can. You can exceed your own expectations. You can shine and still be humble. I am so proud of my class, and I'm so excited to see the impact that you're going to make in the world. With that, I introduce you to the graduating class of 2020.
Make the most of every second you are given. Know that no tomorrow is ever guaranteed. Pursue your dreams and reach for the stars. You can do it. Thanks for making me TPS proud. Thank you.
Burroughs faculty and staff would like to congratulate the class of 2020. You truly have made history. Whatever comes your way, we know you will be successful. Good luck.
Thank you. I want you to take a deep breath and just savor this moment. Graduation is a huge accomplishment under any circumstances, but what you have accomplished over the past few months is truly extraordinary. You have been able to be flexible, be adaptable, keep your eye on your goal, and you've succeeded. Here you are, graduating from high school today. Congratulations. You know, this is what life is like. It's unpredictable. It moves and it shifts, and you have to be able to move and shift with it. You have demonstrated that you are resilient, and that is a huge characteristic you will take with you for the rest of your life. So congratulations. You should be really proud of yourselves. I'm really proud of you, and I can't wait to see the amazing things you do in the future.
Thank you. I have the honor of introducing the Class of 2020 E.L. Bowsher Award. This student is a yet involved, motivated, and hardworking. They are a runner for the Bowsher track and cross country teams. This student is a member of Student Council, National Honor Society, and volunteers for many different causes. They have challenged themselves academically, taking AP and honors classes throughout high school. This student would like to pursue a career as a pediatric psychiatrist and major in biology or psychology. They want to help others and display the kind heart and compassion to do so. Their plan is to attend Heidelberg University. From all the staff here at Bowsher High School, we wish you well in your future endeavors and good luck in all that you choose to do. We are happy to present the E.L. Bowsher Award. You deserve it. Dejanay Witcher.
We seniors would like to thank you to a teacher here at Bowsher High School who has made a huge impact on most of us at some point in our high school career. This teacher is fun, caring, adaptable in their way of teaching to ensure that all other students can be on their path to succeed. They have put their heart and passion to teaching students how to prepare for college in a way of writing, critical thinking. Thank you, Ms. Bell, for all you have done for all your students. Friends, at this time, get your cap and tassel ready. On three, move your tassel from the right to the left. One, two, three. Congratulations, now let's go chase our dreams.
Hi, this is Wade Kapsakavich, Mayor of the City of Toledo. On behalf of the City of Toledo, I would like to congratulate all of you, the Toledo Public Schools Class of 2020, on your graduation. This is an unprecedented time for you and for all of us. What we are going through as a city and as a country, none of us have ever seen in our lifetimes. And I know that you have missed out on some things. And it might be easy to focus on some of those things that you didn't get a chance to do. Not being able to walk in a ceremony. Not being able to have a senior prom or the end of your sports season, or maybe a theatrical production, or any one of a number of things that unfortunately had to be canceled. And it would be normal and it would be human nature to focus on the things you missed out on. But I hope you pause and reflect on what you gained during this moment. You will always remember that you graduated from high school during this unique moment in time. And while it was a time that we were required to be distant from one another physically, it was also a time that we were reminded how important it is to continue to connect with each other emotionally and spiritually. Even as we have been physically distanced, we've seen how important it is to remain connected on those things that matter. People helping those in need, people calling someone who maybe doesn't have any family and is lonely and just needs to hear a warm and loving voice. People have stepped up in so many ways with donations of their time and their treasure in a way that gives me hope that perhaps we can unite as a community and as a country in ways that we haven't in an awful long time. We've been so divided, unfortunately, as a country for so long. I am hopeful that your moment in time, as you graduate, you'll remember that the lesson of this time is how much we need each other and how connected we are to one another. And if you can take that lesson to heart and apply it throughout your lives, if you remember the real lesson of this time, if you remember that your senior year, we were called to rededicate ourselves to connecting with each other in meaningful ways, you will have learned the most important lesson of this time. It will be the greatest graduation gift you can have, and you will live productive, happy, and fulfilling lives as you go forward, no matter what you do, because ultimately, we really are all connected, and that is the lesson of what we're going through, and I hope that is the lesson you take away from your senior year. Again, on behalf of the City of Toledo, congratulations and best wishes.
There comes a time when we heed a certain call, and the world must come together as one.
There are people dying, it's time to lend a hand to life, the greatest gift of all.
We can't go on pretending day by day that someone somewhere will soon make a change.
We are all a part of God's great big family, and the truth, you know, love is all we need.
We are the world, we are the children.
We are the ones who make a brighter day, so let's start giving.
There's a choice we're making, we're saving our own lives.
It's true, we make a brighter day, just you and me.
Oh, send them your heart, so they know that someone cares, and their lives will be stronger and free.
As God has shown us, by turning stones to bread, so we all must lend a helping hand.
We are the world, we are the children.
We are the ones who make a brighter day, so let's start giving.
Oh, there's a choice making, we're saving our own lives.
It's true, we make a better day, just you and me.
We are the world, we are the children. We are the ones who make a brighter day, so let's start giving.
There's a choice we're making, we're saving our own lives.
It's true, we make a brighter day, just you and me.
We are the world, we are the children.
We are the ones who make a brighter day,
let's
start giving.
There's a choice we're making, we're saving our lives.
It's true, we make a better day, just you and me.
It's true, we make a better day.